That's right, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Christian Role Warrior. And what we're going to be dealing with today, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, is Ringling Brothers for Life. That's right. You guys are getting a real treat now that the Christian Role Warrior is having a break from school. A little after Easter break. And I just happened to run across this video by Ringling Brothers here. Talking about an Ohio pastor who puts a stripper pole in the church. Now, when I first saw it, you know, the title and began to listen to him, I was like, wow, man, what kind of crazy pastor is doing this, you know, because, of course, that doesn't sound right, a stripper pole in church, right? But this is a classic case, ladies and gentlemen, of how Ringo is just a bitter man who is now doing anything and everything he can to fight against Christianity because he's you know, been duped by Creflo Dollar Ministries, by his own admission, and now he's going to do anything and everything he can to fight the church. Kind of like Paul in his zeal, but Paul's heart was in the right place. He was just, you know, he was just, I think he said something about zeal without knowledge or what have you. But see, Paul was, I think he said himself he did it in ignorance. But this guy, there's no ignorance here because, you know, as I looked into the situation a little more deeply, this guy just took that whole situation way out of context. Something the devil does, you know, like in Matthew chapter 4 when he took scripture out of context, quoting scripture to Jesus. So this is exactly the same type of thing. This Ohio pastor didn't have a stripper pole in church and women sliding down a pole, because that obviously would have been wrong. But this is the impression that Ringling Brothers gives you in the video. And I'm going to play part of the video here and let you hear his distortion of the issue. Then I'm going to play a news clip of the pastor himself explaining the situation. Okay, and once you see what the pastor says and see the real reason for the stripper pole in the church, along with the other things that he had in the church on the bed and whatnot, you'll understand that there's nothing wrong with what the pastor was attempting to do, either biblically or otherwise. But let me let you hear Ringo's little distortion of the situation. It's sad. It's absolutely sad, man.
Something else will fall in its place. But you don't need the madness that you're seeing in these churches. It's just ridiculous, man. I mean, imagine you bringing kids in the church and, you know, they see a bed on stage with a pole. Are they going to really want to follow the Most High? When they hear you in the church talking up against strippers, oh, these strippers and these strip clubs, and they're condemning strip clubs, they're condemning rappers, and they're condemning the nightclub, and yet when you go in these churches, it's the same thing.
You see, that's the stupidity, because it's not the same thing. The pastor was teaching, and like I said, I'm going to let the pastor speak for himself in a news clip that I'm going to show you after this.
You know, the strip club is there, the pole dancing is there, they got the bed made out. I mean,
ain't no pole dancing going on. Stupidness.
And come on now, it's no different. You know, these Christian churches, they condemn nightclubs, but yet the Christian church is a nightclub. They got all the music jamming, everybody tearing up the floor, women shaking their behind in the church. And you know, in some of these churches, man, when these women be dancing, they don't be dancing like they dancing for the...
See, here's the thing. Now, notice over here, he's got a woman, okay, sliding down a pole with a cross here. Now, if anything, that's more offensive than what the pastor was doing. But okay, that's all right for him to do that in his video. Okay.
Most High. They be shaking their behind like they up in the club. And you have brothers that are right behind them in the church looking at their behind like, man, this lady moving a little too seductive in the church. But this is what's happening.
Now, I can attest that, yeah, this does happen in the church. But the other side of the issue is you have women, you know, mothers in the church that will come or brothers that'll talk to the mothers and say, look, this sister right here, she's a little bit off the chain and she's doing a little too much. Can you talk to her? And they will bring her aside and talk to her and correct that mess. You see what I'm saying? See, that's the other side of the story. You don't hear from Ringling Brothers. You see? Anyway, but see, he's so busy trying to find fault, he can't see the plank in his own eye. Worrying about somebody else's speck.
So how is a person to concentrate on the Most High when you got all of this stuff in the church? And that's why a lot of people pack the Christian church, because it's like a club. It's a semi-nightclub that you can go to find women, to find men, to find sex, to find whatever you want to find. You can find it in the Christian church. Because women in the Christian church are ready to have sex. They're ready to go to bed right away. They meet a man in the same day and they with him. Why? Because they're filled with sexual lust. Because that's all the church is about now. They're not teaching you to obey the Most High. They're teaching you...
Now that's a lie.
...to obey your desires. So again, ladies and gentlemen, this is put out there. I shared my thoughts.
Yeah, your distorted thoughts, man. All right, so you've heard what this guy had to say. Just lots of distortion, maybe just a little bit of truth, just like the devil give you a little bit of truth, you know, just enough so that he reels you in, and then, bam, here's the lie, bam, here's the distortion. Even a little scripture thrown in there for good measure to make you think he know what he's talking about. All right, now that you've heard the distortion of the issue about the Ohio pastor with the stripper pole in his church, I'm going to let you check out what the pastor had to say for himself, because he did a news interview, and I you know, did some research after I saw this foolishness to find out what the real deal was. So you check it out, and you make up your mind as to what the facts are.
First it was the boxing priest, now it's time to meet another unconventional pastor. And this one has a stripper pole in his church.
It's part of his religious sermon on sex and relationships, and it's raising plenty of eyebrows.
Some of the answers lie in our sexual values.
Pastor Mike Scruggs from Ohio in the US knows how to draw a crowd.
We talk about sex, we talk about drugs, we talk about faith. We talk about, you know, relationships, everything that, you know, that people are dealing with on a day-to-day basis.
Not only does his preaching push the boundaries, so do his visual props, a stripper pole and a bed. It's part of his provocative sermon called Battle of the Sexes, where he talks about how to keep intimacy alive and the differences between men and women.
With our bed, you know, on one side of the bed, you're dealing with you know, what men are desiring, what men want. So you have your stripper pole, you have your video games, your sports. The women's side is, you know, obviously the bed is orderly, everything's neat, everything's in its place. It's all about love.
Pastor Mike also encourages married couples in his congregation to have sex 7 days a week. He even has one night dedicated to singletons.
Well, Mike joins us now. Good morning to you. It's nice to meet you. Just explain to us your style of preaching, and do you think that you push the envelope, but purposely?
Good morning to all of you all there in the land down under. I thank you for having me this morning. For us, pushing the envelope, it's a norm. So I guess we're kind of used to doing out-of-the-box ministry. It's just part of, you know, our way of being relevant to our today's society.
Okay. Tell us about this sort of 7 straight days of nookie. What's that meant to do?
For that, that's strictly for our married couples. Right now we have what we're called the month of consecration. And so we said during this month we wanted to do, since we're in this relationship series, we're doing something separate for our singles and then something separate for our married couples. For our married couples, part of that month of consecration, we want them to, of course, read together, pray together. They have to incorporate date night once a week. But then another portion of that was 7 consecutive days of sex. And that's just an opportunity for our married couples to get back to that level of intimacy that you sometimes miss out on when you have children, when there's work involved, when, you know, just regular life kind of pulls at you from every direction. You have to kind of reevaluate things and trying to get back to the original focus.
Mike, you used the word relevant. Do you think a lot of sermons, a lot of churches have basically become irrelevant? They talk about things that no longer apply to our lives?
Yeah, I think that at some point in time, we have to make sure that we are up to date with what everybody else is doing. Yeah. You never should be able to walk into a church and feel like you're going back in time. Right now, we're, you know, the world has television cameras all over the place. Everything is illustrative. You know, you have iPads, you know, your iPhones. Everything's in your face. There's everybody's dealing with an illustrative type of approach in terms of how they want to grab you and get your attention, from movies to television to billboards. And so the church, I think, has to be in the same way, if nothing else, be in the forefront of how all of this is happening. So when you come into church, you shouldn't be able to have to miss out on the same things that you would get, say, if you were going to work or going to school. Even our schools are up to date. Our schools are, you know, advancing with technology. The church should not be the last place to be able to be current with what the rest of the world is doing.
Okay. Mike, thank you for joining us. You talk a lot of sense there. Really appreciate your time.
All right, so now that you've seen the actual clip of the news interview, I'm sure you understand better what was going on, okay? As you can see here on the screen, not only did he have a stripper pole in his illustration on the stage in the church, he had a basketball, he had a video game controller, because he was trying to illustrate the differences between men and women. On the other side of the bed, there was a teddy bear, you know, rose petals. He was being very illustrative. Now, there's nothing wrong with being illustrative. Jesus did the same thing with his parables, talking about farmers and sowing seed and things like that. Nothing wrong with using illustrations, okay? And the Bible does that itself, all over the place. All right. Now if the pastor had women on the pole, sliding down the pole and stripping in front of the congregation, that would have been a problem. You see. And that's how people have distorted this whole thing to be. And it's not. So I just wanted to throw that out there, since I got a little time now, since I'm on vacay from graduate school. And so I just wanted to just give that a little commentary, just in case you missed it. So if anyone talks about this pastor and makes it seem like he's a nasty pastor and he's doing wrong, just tell him to come to the Warrior video to get the facts and the truth undistorted. God bless you. And don't believe the foolish hype from Ringling Brothers for Life or anybody else. What a rush. Gotta know the truth. Yeah.